Hello everyone, so we are here with the second video lecture of our data analysis part, and before this we have seen till graphing of data, and now let's move on to the output which we obtained using the graphing of data. The first one is bar chart. So in a bar chart, a bar shows each category, so the length of which represent the amount, frequency or percentage of values falling into category. So we can see in this example that others are 7%, catching up on work are 5%, vacation on 5%, and these are the length of the data, or we can say that the length of the data represents the frequency or the amount of the value. Next is pie chart. So similarly, in pie chart the length is depicted by the slice size, that is how thick the slice is. So the pie chart is a circle broken up into slices that represents category, and the size of each slice of the pie varies according to the percentage in each category. Next is line graph. Line graph is with respect to the time, and it displays trends over time. So we can see that the number of clinicians working in each clinic during year 1, 2, 3, 4 are depicted by this line. Next is histogram. So it is a graph of the data in a frequency distribution, and this is done with the help of the intervals that are in this example. We are given with 5 15 25 35 45 55. So these are the intervals, and on the y-axis we are having the frequency. Next is polygon or object. So a percentage polygon is formed by having the midpoint of each class. So midpoint of each class is depicted, and it is represented the data in that class, and then connecting the sequence of midpoints at their respective class percentage. So we can see that there are class from 0 to 10, and we are having midpoint as 5. Similarly, here we are having midpoint as 15. So all the midpoints are connected, and these midpoints form a polygon. Let's move on to our main part of this topic, that is analysis of data. So analysis means computation of certain indices or measure, along with searching for patterns of relationship that exist among the data group. So analysis means the analyzing of the data which we have collected in our collection phase. So these are the hierarchical types, or we can say that the process of analysis of data. So it is done by two process. The first one is descriptive and causal analysis, and the second one is inferential or statistical analysis. Under descriptive and causal, we are having three analysis types, that are univariate, bivariate and multivariate. And under inferential or statistical analysis, we are having two, that are estimation of parameter values and testing hypothesis. So under estimation, we are having two again, the point estimate and interval estimate. And under testing hypothesis, we are having two, that are parametric test and non-parametric test. So let's see each and every analysis. So first one is descriptive analysis. So as the name suggests, the study of distribution of variables is termed as descriptive analysis. And if we are studying one variable, then it will be termed as a univariate analysis. In the case of two variables, it is known as bivariate analysis, and in case of multivariate analysis, in this case we know that is three or more than three variables are used. So in univariate analysis, univariate analysis refers to the analysis of one variable at a time, and the most common approach are as follows. The first one is distribution table and diagrams, that are bar chart, pie chart, histogram, and some measures of central tendency, that are arithmetic mean, that are mean, median, mode, which we have already studied in our previous lecture, and measures of dispersion, that are range, mean deviation and standard deviation. Similarly, we are having bivariate analysis. In this bivariate analysis, it is concerned with the analysis of two variables at a time in order to uncover whether the two variables are related or not. So the first one is its main types are simple correlation, simple regression and two-way ANOVA. So we have already studied these topics. Next is multivariate analysis. So multivariate analysis entails the simultaneous analysis of three or more variables. So its main types are multiple correlation, multiple regression, and multi ANOVA. So causal analysis. It is concerned with the study of how one or more variables affect changes in other variables. So in this causal analysis, it reflects the things which are related to one variable and another variable. Next is inferential analysis. So it is concerned with the testing the hypothesis and estimating the population value based on the sample value. So according to the sample value, the testing of hypothesis is done and the estimation of the population is calculated. Next is parametric test. So these tests depends upon assumptions typically that the populations from which data are randomly sampled have a normal distribution. And in this calculating the normal distribution, we are having the type of tests, the parametric tests that are t-test, z-test, f-test, chi-square test. Also, we have some non-parametric tests that is do not involve population parameters. So for example, we are having probability distribution, independence, and data measured on any scale. So ratio or interval, ordinal or nominal, these are the things. So that's all for this video, and I am giving you one more additional video, the supplementary video for the types of data analysis. So that in that video we are having the some software or the tools which we commonly use for data analysis, and do follow those tools and keep learning. Thank you.